Tudo bom, pessoal? Hoje eu trouxe um vídeo aqui para vocês para falar sobre uma questão que virou uma grande polêmica aqui nos Estados Unidos. Muitas pessoas estão perguntando sobre essa questão do furlough dos funcionários da USCIS, né? São mais de 13 mil pessoas que podem ser afastadas a qualquer momento em razão de uma crise financeira pela qual eles estão passando. Lembrem que são 20 mil funcionários que eu já falei faz tempo que eles estão trabalhando num ritmo um pouco mais desacelerado, e agora existe essa chance deles serem realmente afastados se não houver um socorro financeiro do governo. Para isso eu trouxe aqui meu amigo, meu parceiro, meu irmão Jason Ditch de novo para falar com vocês. Eu vou falar em português e eu peço para vocês que coloquem a tradução automática do YouTube. Vocês vão ver que o YouTube traduz automaticamente o que ele falar para vocês. Então eu vou fazer a pergunta em português, vou falar para ele em inglês, não vou colocar essa parte para o vídeo não ficar muito longo, para vocês entenderem a pergunta e para ele responder, vocês coloquem a tradução automática, certo? Jason, once again, thank you very much.
Glad to be here.
So, just say hello.
Hello, everybody.
Well, Jason, what do you think about the furlough and what's going on with USCIS? And so what's your opinion about all these things?
Well, let me first say that as we know that lots of rumors go around about these things, and especially potential immigrants to our country get to hear all kinds of things from all different people. So I like to cut through the rumors and I like to listen to people who actually have experience with the USCIS. So what I've been doing is I've been reading statements made by former employees of the USCIS, such as their their number one lawyer who was there for years until last year. And what I've determined is this: right now the USCIS is in a difficult financial position. However, they're telling the government that they need $1.2 billion to stay alive, not for 2020, not for this fiscal year, but for 2021. However, this $1.2 billion figure was actually first stated back in April, right before COVID hit. Mm-hmm. Granted, we did have a very significant shortfall in visa applications because of COVID. However, visa applications picked up again in June and the money came way up, and they were actually making more money than they anticipated in April. So this $1.2 billion number, we believe, is not real. We believe it's closer to somewhere around $250 million. However, it doesn't matter, because right now there will be a shortfall, and there is a plan to furlough 75% of the USCIS workforce. In real numbers, that's 13,400 employees out of 20,000. So obviously it makes sense that if they do institute this furlough, that they're going to be working with a skeleton crew, mm-hmm. and it's going to be very difficult to process the applications that they ordinarily will process.
And probably take longer.
Correct. So what I've been when I've been listening to the people that really know, that used to be with the highest lawyers up at the USCIS, they believe that the furlough date, which right now is set for the end of August, will actually be moved back till probably the end of September, if not later. Additionally, there won't be any money given to the USCIS as a standalone, I shouldn't say that. There was initially a hope that the USCIS would get their money through a COVID-19 relief bill. Mm-hmm. Well, as many people know, Congress is not in Congress right now. They are all back in their home districts for what we call our summer recess. Mm-hmm. So there is no legislation on the table right now, and that won't happen until after Labor Day. So really the only way the USCIS can get their money at this point is through a standalone piece of legislation, which again is going to be very difficult when the legislators are not in Washington. So what we believe is that the furlough date will likely be extended till at least the end of September, if not later. And then when the legislators come back, there will be a fairly quick resolution to the money problem, because as I stated earlier, this $1.2 billion number is not a real number. It's closer to $250 million, somewhere around there. It's still a lot of money, but it's not so much that they shouldn't, that Congress should not be able to appropriate that money and allow the USCIS to continue business as usual. So what does that mean to potential immigrants, applicants for visas here in the United States? I think that it's a good idea to, you know, continue on as business as usual. As I said, there is a chance that the furlough may actually happen, in which case things will slow down at the USCIS. However, everything is going to be done to prevent this furlough from happening. We're talking about many, many jobs that are at stake here. People who are actually right now don't even know what's going to happen are actually out there. I'm talking about USCIS employees are out there looking for other jobs. So even if they do save the organization, there is a possibility they'll have an employee shortfall anyway. So we do believe that they're going to do everything they can to come up with the money that's going to be necessary to keep the USCIS open and functioning properly. So it's our opinion that it's in everybody's best interest that if you are seeking to make an application for a visa and or a green card, to just go ahead as business as usual, file the application, and you know, the best we can tell you is we'll see what happens from here, but we feel very confident that things will be progressing as business as usual.
Okay. Do you think maybe Trump is using this situation to get his reelection?
I think that's a huge part of what's going on. As we know, Trump is very far behind in the polls as far as, you know, all the current polling is going on. So he's doing everything in his power to try to, you know, bring his prospects for reelection up. And this is one way that he's, you know, chosen to do that. Unfortunately, it's at the expense of, you know, hardworking people who will add a lot to the U.S. economy.
Yeah.
And he's not looking at it like that. To him, it's all about his reelection. And it's unfortunate, but this is U.S. politics.
Yeah. Actually, it's world's politics.
This is true.
Everybody does that. Okay, man. Thank you very much again.
It's my pleasure.
Gente, muitíssimo obrigado. Eu queria trazer essa opinião dele para vocês. Muitas pessoas perguntando, muitas pessoas em dúvida, inseguras. Eu acho que não há razão para essa insegurança. Quis trazer o Jason aqui para falar para vocês sobre essa questão. Não acho que deve ter algum tipo de paralisação efetiva. Talvez um corte, mas não nesse tamanho todo que eles imaginam, porque o número realmente é bem inferior àquele que foi colocado lá atrás. Pode haver? Pode, mas não acho que vai ser de grande impacto como as pessoas estavam imaginando e da forma que estava sendo desenhado em razão dessa questão política. Grande abraço, fiquem com Deus. Obrigado, Jason. Thank you very much.
Obrigado, everybody.